Hello everyone, and welcome to a calm, sunny summer afternoon back in late June. I was high up in the mountains helping out on a flower farm that was getting ready for a wedding when I looked down into some of those wedding-destined flowers and discovered this little one. Isn't he just the most vibrant caterpillar ever? And he's so big, I could hardly believe his sheer size or how rich and vibrant his coloration was. And he could have cared less that I was fascinated in watching him. He was much more interested in continuing his steady progress and rather quickly eating down a bunch of florist Queen Anne's lace that was meant for a wedding, but was quickly turning into his meal instead. I loved sitting still and watching this little one as he ate. You can see as he uses his front feet to grasp and pull the slender leaves of the florist Queen Anne's lace into his mouth so he can begin chewing it down, and he eats so quickly too. I was very excited to find him, but let's just say that the florist and the bride involved were not so pleased to see him very quickly working his way through their plants. And I can't really blame them. Left alone in the wedding bouquet, he probably could have caused quite a bit of drama in a very short time by eating down all the flowers that had been meticulously grown, especially for that special day, over a period of several months, and there were no other flowers around, so I did everyone a favor by taking him and his little Queen Anne's lace, just one of them, and putting him aside for the time being. However, I was totally charmed. I brought this little one and his meal home so he could escape a far less pleasant fate at the flower farm and studied up on him. What we have here is actually the last instar of a black swallowtail butterfly. Instar is the term that refers to a life stage for arthropods between molting. In other words, what they look like during different stages of their life. I didn't know it, but it turns out many caterpillar species molt and change color and shape several times before reaching their final instar stage, before they pupate. So you will actually have a caterpillar that will change its shape, size, coloration, and still look like a caterpillar several times before they work their way to becoming a chrysalis and a butterfly. In this case, we caught this little one right before he pupated. In fact, that is actually a story you might see in a future vlog. This brightly colorful green with black stripes and white dots stage is the fourth instar for the black swallowtail butterfly, which is also known as the eastern black swallowtail, the American black swallowtail, or the parsnip swallowtail. They can be found throughout most of North America, but prefer the tropical and temperate places with the delicious plants that they love. They eat a lot of members of the carrot family, and they really seem to love fennel and Queen Anne's lace, so he ate quite a bit of that too. And that's a good thing that I got him out because the particular wedding bouquet that he had perched himself in was made primarily of florist Queen Anne's lace. Many of the plants are toxic to other animals, like the Queen Anne's lace, but this little guy is going to absorb all those toxins, and that is going to make him toxic to any curious birds or other animals who might want to try to eat him, which is why he can get away with having such bright colors, because it's a warning to the curious predators not to nibble on him. He's absolutely beautiful and definitely an upgrade from the earlier instars of the black swallowtail butterfly, which are designed to look more like bird poop. No joke. I had a wonderful time studying him and it was just such an amazing find, and he was the biggest caterpillar I've ever seen. So I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I can't wait to show you some more of my adventures here in the Appalachian Mountains. Until next time everyone, stay curious!